Hi, my name is Tom Lab, and I'm with Simply Virtual, and this is SilverTech. Hi, this is Tom Lavin from Simply Virtual, Inc., and this is SilverTech. SilverTech is a series of short tutorials to help you better understand how to use your tablet, your laptop, your cell phone. And today we're going to talk about setting up a Gmail account. A Gmail account is important for several reasons, not the least of which is a Gmail account actually allows you to use your Android device even more efficiently, because Google owns the Android device operating system. So the Gmail account is important for the effective use of those devices. Gmail also has a number of other applications that it offers, not the least of which is YouTube. And so what we're going to do, as we talked about in the last video, we're going to talk about setting up a Gmail account. So essentially what you're going to do is, from your browser or from your Google homepage, you're going to type in Google account. The search results will give you a hyperlink that says Google, set up your Google account, and you're going to click on that. It's going to take you to a screen that says all of Google working for you, and it's going to give you a couple different options, one of which is create an account, and the other one is go to a Google account. Well, we don't have a Google account yet, so we're going to click on create an account. When you get there, you're going to get to a page that says create your Google account, and it's going to ask you for your first name, your last name, and then it's going to ask you for a username that is going to be the name for your Gmail account. Now, back in the day, I've been with Gmail probably since its inception, and I have my first name and my last name at gmail.com. You may be in a situation where you have to add some numbers or some letters to make your email account unique, but it will always tell you whether or not your email address is available. If for some reason you type in something and it says it's not available, it will always suggest another email address that could work. If you find that that's an option for you, you can choose that, or you can continue to try to manipulate the name. Occasionally what we find is people put periods between their first and last name. Oftentimes we'll see periods between their first name, last name, maybe last name first, adding numbers, adding characters, things of that nature to make the email address unique. Once the screen tells you that your unique email is available, you'll be asked to put in a password. I have to reiterate how important it is for you to keep that password with you, and we'll talk about saving passwords on devices like that in another tutorial. But you'll want to be saving your password. It's asking you to put in your password and then to confirm the password. Now, I should say that the email address is not case specific, meaning it doesn't really respond to upper and lower case as your in your email address. What does respond to upper and lower case is your password. So if you set up your password as Normandy Apartments, you might put capital N, capital A. You may also put in, and some of the passwords require you to put in other characters like dollar signs, the ampersand sign, perhaps the pound sign. And those signs also make it more difficult for people to figure out your password. One of the things you may want to check so that you can confirm that your passwords match is you may want to click a button below that that says show password. Typically, when you type in the password, it'll show dots, and that way it'll keep your password secure even from anybody looking over your shoulder. But if you're in a private setting, feel free to click show password. Then you're going to click next. And what Next is going to do is it's going to complete your registration of your password. It's going to ask you a couple questions, and in every case, you can pretty much accept what they're asking you. Now, once you set up your Google account, it's going to take you to a main page where it's going to welcome you, and it's also going to give the options of doing some things with respect to personalizing your Gmail account. Now, there's a couple different ways to do that. One of them, in the upper right-hand corner, you're going to see a circle with the first initial of your first name. You can click on that, or you can go to the left-hand side of your screen where the options for home, personal info, data and privacy, security, people and sharing, payments and subscriptions. One of where you're going to do your personalization is under personal info, where you can add things like your photo, your birthday, you can add your gender if you wish, you can add your contact information, including your phone number, and oftentimes by putting your phone number there, it allows you to secure your account. So if for some reason you have forgotten your password, that phone number will be texted a message to allow you to reclaim or change your password if you wish. One of the other things that you'll see from that main page is just to the left, if you go to the upper right-hand corner of the screen, just to the left, you're going to see a series of 9 dots. When you click on those 9 dots, that allows you access to all of the applications that are provided by your Google account. So it could be a Google page that allows you to search. Google Maps. Google Maps is a wonderful application that takes you from where you are to where you want to go in the quickest way possible. There's our YouTube application. There's our YouTube icon. Google Play. We're going to have a tutorial on Google Play where you can download applications from games to news sites to other sports related things. Your Gmail account, that's how you might access Gmail in order to read your email. Google Drive is another tutorial we'll be doing. The calendar, photos, Google Meet, all of those are things that we'll discuss in future episodes of these tutorials. But effectively, what you've done now is you've unlocked with your Google email address all of those options that you can access, and it just expands your Google universe to no end. I appreciate you watching today. This is Tom Webb with Simply Virtual. This is SilverTech. Again, I want to thank the Breakwater Apartments at Normandy for allowing us our location, and we will see you next time.